Hello everyone, we continue with regulated DC power supply. So far we discussed about the types of regulators. There are basically two types of regulators are there, a series regulator and shunt regulator. In this we are starting with the first one, that is transistor series voltage regulator. In that the transistor is in series with the load, that's why it is called as a series transistor regulator. In this also we maintain the constant output voltage, but it having a two drawbacks, two limitation. That is, we know very well the output voltage, it depends upon base emitter voltage and Zener voltage, and both are sensitive to temperature. So that we starting another type of the regulator, that is series feedback regulator. It will give you a constant output voltage, and that constant output voltage will not depend on the Zener diode voltage or base emitter voltage. So we find it out that output voltage is equal to the SCL times the closed loop voltage gain times the sum of Zener voltage and base emitter voltage. But in series regulators, in a series feedback regulator, we are having two transistors. One transistor is called as a pass transistor. It is called pass transistor because all the load current will pass through that transistor Q2, as shown in the circuit. So sometimes a pass transistor may be destroyed. Pass transistor may be destroyed due to the excessive load current. If load is accidentally shorted, then the high amount of current will flow, and it may leads to destroy of the transistors. To avoid such an eventual incidents, one circuit is added. That circuit is called as a current limiting circuit. That circuit is called as a current limiting circuit, which is added in the series with the regulator to provide a protection to our pass transistor, and that circuit is called as a short circuit protection. Short circuit protection. See, as shown in the circuit diagram, it is very much similar to the our series feedback regulator, transistor Q1 and transistor Q2, and we are the resistor R2 will be responsible for a feedback voltage, and it will produce a negative feedback by using transistor. But one more circuit added over here, that is seen in the circuit diagram, one transistor Q3 and one resistance R4, that is of 1 omega. This two will forms a short circuit protection to the pass transistor. So the current limiting circuit, it consists of a transistor Q3 and a series resistor R4 that will be connected between base and emitter terminal of the transistor Q3. One resistor R4, that is of 1 omega, is connected across the base and emitter of the transistor Q3, and that is responsible to provide a protection to our pass transistor Q2 if there will be a accidentally shorting of the load occur. How that will be occurs? First, when load current is normal, that is ultimately what is our expectation. Okay, when load current is normal, the voltage across the resistor R4, that is of 1 omega, the voltage across the resistor R4 is equal to voltage across the base emitter of the transistor Q3. When the load current is normal, the voltage across the resistor R4 is equal to the voltage across the base emitter of the Q3. If is a small and Q3 is small, when load current is normal, so ultimately we can say that the voltage across resistor R4 is very small. Very small, so we can call that transistor Q3 is off. Under this condition, the circuit is works as we know very well, the series transistor feedback. If load current become excessive because of the due to the some accidents of the sorting of the load resistance will be occur. If a load current will be increases, what happen? The voltage across the resistor R4, that is 1 omega, or we'll call that the voltage across the base emitter of the transistor Q3 become large. And because of the excess voltage drop across the transistor base, a transistor Q3 will turn on. As the transistor Q3 is turned on, the collector current of the Q3 will force through the R3. Say as shown in the circuit, the collector terminal of the Q3 is connected to the R3. The collector current of the Q3 will force through the resistor R3, and that will leads to decrease. That will leads to decrease the base voltage of the transistor Q2. And decreasing in the base voltage of the transistor Q2 reduce the conduction of the pass transistors. Pass transistor will not be conduct, or if it conduct, then it got minimum voltage. And it will be prevent your pass transistor from the further increase of the load current. And load current of the circuit is limited to the 700 milliampere. So this is the short circuit protection. Once again, what is purpose of the short circuit protection? We know very well, all the load current will pass through the transistor Q2. If there will be some accidental sorting of the load resistance occur, there will be excess current will flows through the pass transistor, and this may lead to the destroy of a transistor. For that purpose, we have to adding one current limiting circuit is series with the regulator, which is consist of transistor Q3 and resistor R4 of 1 omega. If it is normal load current will flow, then there will be a minimum voltage drop across the transistor Q3 and it will be off. If there will be a load current will be excess or increase due to the sorting of the load resistor, the voltage across resistor R4 or the voltage across the base emitter of the Q3 will increase, and that leads to turn on of a transistor Q3. And because of that, that collector current will flows through R3, and that will decrease the base voltage of the Q2, and this reduce the conduction of that pass transistors. So this way we will provide the short circuit to the series feedback regulator. So this is about the series voltage regulator. Thank you.